Hey, horse people. Yeah, that picture I posted with a Moki cat injury was I took it earlier from his earlier picture. So he's healed up now. But I want to cover old Mr. T. He's getting his normal itchy, scratchy crap, man. It's just like almost overnight it comes. So he's eating his grain. I got Buddy in there eating his little grain. I give him a little snack, just kind of like to keep him appeased while Mr. T eats his senior food. So Mr. T, as you can tell, he's got his war paint on. He's ready to go to battle. Poor old Mr. T. So this is basically Desinex. It's that white cream you put on a baby's butt. I think it's whatever. I got the Equate kind of version, but it's the same thing. It's really hard. I always judge on how good things stay on a horse is how hard it is for me to wash off my hands after I put it on them. So I put this on him and it took me two or three with, where's Moki on? Where you going, boy? Moki cat, where are you going? Going to the shade bed. Rabbit's out there eating his carrot. You can kind of see him in the corner there. See him right? Where's he at? Right there. He's eating his banana now. Let me give you a close-up on him because he'll be disappearing. They disappear like freaking crazy. I can't ever keep up with him. So he's eating. He already ate part of his carrot. You can tell. I don't give him a whole carrot. And he's still a little flighty of me unless I'm bringing him food. So I'm okay with that because I don't want to take away his ability to survive. He's digging another hole in here over there. So he might have been a little culprit in my water tank digging. You're in big trouble. I catch you digging, boy. You're going to get spanking. Buddy, say hi to YouTubies. He's like, dude, I'm cleaning up my snack. I spread it out so he thinks he's got a lot. It takes him a while to eat it. Rick, that's mean. You're making him work. Oh, be quiet. He's a big pig. He'll suck all that up. Oh, there's one of those damn carpenter bees. I made these carpenter bee traps. And there's another one. Oh, man, they're a pain in the butt. So they drill these holes. You see that hole right there? I kind of sprayed some fly spray. Obviously, it didn't deter him from digging. You can see the sawdust. And they will literally just eat away your barn and make your wood structure fall down. It's crazy. And I'm freaking killing them left and right, and I just cannot get rid of them. I made these little traps with some honey. Drill a hole. I did a video on how to make them if you want to make them. I don't know if I'd make them because they ain't freaking working. What do I got? I got two freaking bugs in there. They've been up there for a day, and I got two freaking bugs. So I'm not impressed. There's these two knuckleheads right here. Chewing the shit out of my barn right here on YouTube. I got evidence on you guys. I know there's some freaking idiot out. Why don't you sue them? Why don't you take them to court? And then you shouldn't hurt them. They pollinate. They're good. Why are you trying? Look, they're tearing up. And now I'll have the other idiots come here. Rick, if you just painted it, work. I painted the shit. I put the spray. I got spray paint. They still chew through it. So, I mean, these guys are just... they're like digging fools. See, there was a hole back there that I squirted. Sometimes I can squirt them with the fly spray and they'll go down, but I gotta hit them really good. Let's see if I can get a fly spray on this guy. Look out, little rabbit. I got a spray. It's like, dude, don't be spraying me. Come on. Oh man, the rabbit knocked him down. No, he got away. Oh, got him. So I just wasted like $14 in fly spray for him to fly away. Freaking irritate the crap out of me. You got flies on you, buddy? I don't see any flies on you. You're looking pretty good today. I'll give you a couple little squirts. But I don't think they're on you today. Sometimes they come out, sometimes they don't. Anyway, there's a banana he's eating. There's his freaking carrot. Hopefully I didn't spray it with poison. Rick, you're gonna kill that rabbit. You're gonna get so much advice. Anyway, here's Rickon. I don't mind a good advice. It's the whining lack of experience, never done it advice. The people that just run around the internet and tell everybody how much they know, but they don't do anything. So anyway, this Desinex Not sure if T's feet look pretty good.
I'm sitting here staring at his feet. I always check out a horse's feet. Buddy needs a feet job. Mr. T, he's looking pretty good. I think I did him maybe a couple weeks ago. I can't remember.
I lose track of time. I just look at them when they look like they need done. I do them. So anyway, wherever you see the Desinex is a scrape or a rub mark where he's losing hair because he's rubbing. Now the white on his butt here is sweat. And that's just from him sweating in the sun and it turns white. I could probably just kind of brush that away and it would go away. Because that's just a little salt. Never knew it was there. Ooh, Mr. T, good old boy. Hey, good old horsey boy. So I got the vet. I got the vet coming out next week. You notice this side, there's not quite as much rubbing. He really rubbed on that one side. And he rubs around his ears. So I'll try to get a close up here. He doesn't like when I get a close up, but I'll try.
Yeah, see, that ain't gonna work.
Look at that damn, hang on. Hey, I gotta get a close up for YouTubies. Hang on. I know, come on, easy. It's okay, I know, I wanna get a close up. I know. So that's the ear on the back and on the front. And he had a couple little spots like right there. I gotta get the other side, hang on. I know, it's scary. I know, mean old camera's all over you. I know, say, Dad, you just rubbed that stinky crap all over me. Get away from me, stupid human. All right, so that's a close up of Mr. T's war paint. Woo, 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 woo. I don't know if I can do that, man. Is that even allowed now? There's so much freaking censorship out there. Can I go, woo, 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 woo. Mr. T's like, stupid human. All right, so I'll leave Mr. T alone. Moki's over there. So, all right, so we got all the critters. And as I was talking, I was gonna sit on this piece of wood. Look at those ants. Little pieces of shit. If I'd have sat on that wood, they'd have been eating my ass. There's one. I see you. Okay, let me piss off some ant lover. Oh, Rick, you should have done that. That was mean. Yep. That's me, just a mean, mean guy. All right, so I digress. We're looking at critters that I take care of and critters that I don't freaking like because they bite me. And I think as I'm talking, one bit me in the leg already. So Smokey hasn't had his shot. I called the vet and I asked for a shot. It's okay, here comes all the hate mail. You're not taking care of those. Look, I do not like getting my horses vaccinated every freaking year. I think it's a scam. I think a lot of people require it. You ready to go back in the barn, boy? All right, come on. I know. Dad's getting distracted. I'm talking about vaccines and now I gotta let my buddy in. All right, come on, old man. Let's get in here. I know, buddy's like, there's my friend. There's your little friend coming in. I know, there's your little friend coming in. Damn, I just got another ant on my leg. I must have been standing in an ant pile somewhere. And speaking of ants, because Mr. T went in there nice, I'll give him a little. Hi, Mr. T. I know you just had yours. We'll give a little handful of just regular old rolled oats. Hang on, buddy. Here's yours. Just a little handful there for a little snack. They'll eat that. Rolled oats. Some people call them steamed oats. See, this says rolled oats. Oh, no. It says steamed and rolled. And it's just easier to digest. This is just alfalfa pellets. And this is a little bit of sweet feed, which is mainly a treat. I don't give them a lot because it's got molasses and all that. A lot of people like to feed too much. Oh, looks like your treat jar is open. These are farina carrot treats. We'll give them a few of those. Good boy, Mr. T. Those are good. Mm. I know you like your little treats because you're a good boy. All right, so let me go back and get on Smokey so I can get some hate mail for being honest. Honesty is the new treason. What is that? In a country of lies, truth is treason. So where the hell did I get those damn ants on me? Those freakers bit the shit out of me. Go put some damn...
Some people say pneumonia or bleach on an ant bite and it stops. It does work pretty good. But how do they get on my freaking ankle? Damn.
I don't know where the hell I was standing, but I must have been standing somewhere in them.
So, Mr. T's itching. If you remember, I had that blood test done to see what was causing it, to see if it was the gnats. And what came back high was his ant bites. So he's getting bit by these ants, and that's what's causing his reaction of rubbing and itching. Now, the doc wants to give him that cortisone shot once every 6 months. And I mean, it's people are going to think it's the money, it's for his help and all that. I mean, I think it might be $100 or $130, which, you know, if it brought him comfort for 6 months, I'd do it in a second. But I don't see a big difference, and I just don't like putting chemicals, which brings me back to my other thing about giving them shots, to where I think a lot of vets and a lot of these freaking community barns have made it to where every course has to be wormed 4 times a year, whether they need it or not. You got to prove it. You got to give them their shots. They got to get their shots twice a year to be sure that they don't catch anything, even though once a year, once... Hey, Moki, why'd you come rub on your dad? Oh, mean old aunt's got your dad. They're in big trouble. They're in big trouble. Dad's going to get him an aunt. So I got distracted again. So, what the hell was I talking about? Damn it. Stupid cat. I'm going to beat him when I turn this off for distracting me. What was I talking about? Oh, the ants is what he's having the reaction to. And I go out and I kill the ant mounds and stuff, but... I just don't like giving my horses the shots every year. I'm sorry. I think once every 2 years is probably fine. And I thought it was 2 years. And I called the vet and I go, hey, when was the last time my guys had their shots? And she goes, it looks like it was 2017. I go, oh, shit, it's been 3 years. Now, in those 3 years, have either of my horses died? Have they gotten rhinovirus? Have they gotten tetanus? Have they... You know, well, Rick, you don't know, they could have. And look, if I don't take my horses out to meet a lot of horses. It's these show people, these barn people, to where you have horses coming in and out. You got boarders for a week and then they leave. You got boarders bringing in friends' horses for a week that came across from Mexico and nobody knows where they came from. And they're bringing all these diseases up here. And then you wonder why all these horses are getting sick. So, Moki came over and laid down. What are you doing, boy? You're gonna be in big trouble. Dad's gonna step on you. So that's why I'm not a big fan of giving shots every year. I know some people will think it's mean. Now, if my horses were being exposed, and if I was going to shows, and if I was doing things to where I was running into a bunch of strange horses, because I know horse people are the strangest people around. They all want to own a horse, and nobody wants to put any effort to care for them. Then maybe I would get them vaccinated more. I mean, Texas still requires a freaking, just to travel with my horses, I gotta have a Coggins test. There ain't been a case of Coggins in freaking 30 years. I mean, every once in a while, somebody will bring it from across Mexico, which they don't check. Hell, they can walk across the freaking border. But anyway, Coggins, it's, I think it's $90 to test to see if your horse has Coggins. And if you travel anywhere, you've gotta have a Coggins test with you. I mean, it's just freaking stupid. So I've had one Coggins test since I've been here. And again, my horses don't come in contact. So all you haters can be, he doesn't take care of his horses. He's mean. He's neglecting them. He's cruel. Shut up, you big crybabies. I'm out here trying to please all you idiots. So anyway, it's been 3 years. So I got the vet coming out in a week to give them their shots. Now, another reason I don't like giving shots all the time for Mr. T is he's old. And I just don't like putting all those chemicals. I think putting all that shit in his system probably hurts his immune system more than it helps it. Moki keeps rolling on my foot. I'm going to be like, he's distracting me. He's like, dude, pet me. I'm rolling on you. So every time I take a step back, he moves into me and lays on my foot. You're going to be in big trouble. Buddy's agent's going to be mad because you're getting more video time than he is. Now you're going to get me in trouble with two agents, your agent and Buddy's agent. So there, that's my spiel. All right, I think I got it out. I've been trying to get it out. I give my shots maybe once every 2 years. My neighbor, He hasn't given his horse shots in 10 years. And he's out here with the same skunks and the same everything. And my other neighbor, he hasn't ever given his cows or donkeys or mules or anything shots. Now, I'm not saying that's a good idea, because, you know, he doesn't give hoof care or anything else either, so that's not good. But I take care of my horse's feet. I take care of their health. When I see a change in behavior, I call a vet and we figure out what's going on, or I get them to the vet. And Smokey's out here running around killing mice and everything. He hasn't had his shots in 3 years, which, I mean, he's pretty healthy. And to be honest, I'm not real sure I like putting those chemicals in him, but since he hadn't had it in 3 years, I'll go ahead and get him. So the vet's coming out and we'll get both these guys their shots and the kitty the shot. And that'll be a $500 bill. Everybody's like, how much does it cost to own a horse? Well, when I call the vet out here to give them their shots, it's $500. So, and I know people are going to say you can buy them and you can give them yourself and you can get them in the store. And I did that for a while. I mean, I bought the stuff and gave them their shots and tried to save money. And you know what? I think it's worth paying to me to have a professional vet come out. He'll pick up something else. He'll inspect them. He'll do things that probably should be done. And he may pick up something that I don't. So I don't mind. Plus, I mean, vet's got to make a living. I want him to come out when I need him. And I don't want, you know, to be a stranger to where the only time I call him is when I panic. So if I can throw him a little money to come out, that's fine. So that's I got a low battery. Hopefully that didn't, it's telling me I got to get off. Mokey, why do you keep rolling into me, boy? Good old cat. It's nice and cool. The wind's blowing out here. He's spilling his oats. I know somebody's going to say, maybe he's hungry. I just fed him soft food this morning, and he's got dry food in the garage I just filled up. So he's not hungry. He's got fresh water, so he's not thirsty. So quit trying to come up with excuses for me abusing this crazy cat. Rick, you shouldn't put your foot on him. You're going to give him the corona. Shut up, you big crazy people. All right, we'll end that there. Shit, I was just going to show Mr. T's wounds, and I went on for freaking 17 minutes. All right, we'll end that there. Mokey, your kitty. Let's go see if the rabbit real quick, if he finishes a little carrot or banana. Banana's still there. Nope, he's just chilling out, laying down. Can y'all see him? Stewie, what are you doing, boy? He's like, I'm resting till I tear up some more of your shit and dig a hole somewhere that you don't want. Or I run in the garage just to piss you off. I know what you're doing, boy. All right, we'll end that there. Buddy, Mr. T, you're a good boy. There's one of those damn freaking carpenter bees. Oh, man. All right, we'll end that there.